nothing to repair. There's nothing to repair if you know how to behave respectfully from the get-go. And I think that's really what the professional development is for our teachers, is how to build those caring, creative ecosystems in each classroom. That has to be our goal, and I think that's what we need to prioritize, that's what our administrative regulations need to prioritize, and that's who we need to be if we're going to say we're a whole child, whole community. And it needs to include, and I wish the parents had stayed, it needs to include our parents. She's absolutely right. A child who comes from a toxic environment at home is not going to be healed by coming to school and not having any opportunity to have some of that healing happen at home with the people who are with him or her who also need to be healed. So we have to find a way so that they're brought in and that becomes part of our goal. We need to do whole community. That means families. Families need the healing. And I think that the words that struck me tonight were the importance of healing our community. Because that's what this is about. That's what bullying is about. That's what all of the pain that we're talking about, all of those programs are about. Most people don't know this. In this county of Contra Costa, there are altogether 8 school-based health centers. Do you know that in the county? We have 6 of them. We have 6 of them. No other school district has a full, they don't have any, as a matter of fact. The other 2 are not in school districts. They're in non-school districts. So we are the only school district in the state, in the county. This is a number that was brought to my attention. And really within the state, I was asking, well, what other school districts have school-based health centers in all of their secondary schools in the state? And I couldn't find any. So we are leaders in at least beginning the process and setting the stage for the healing that we need to do. And that's a big first step. But we need the individuals in those, many of them are here, many very strong, powerful people who have very good ideas and are out there. I've gone to Nightmare on Puberty Street. It's a spectacular, wonderful event. But we need something that's here all the time so that every child who needs support has somewhere they can go to. And that is what I hope will be our direction to our staff, that is what we create in the ecosystem of what we want our school district to be. And if we do that, only good things will happen in every possible way for our children and all of our families. So I want to thank everybody who came here tonight, especially the people who've already left, who are not hearing me, but I want everybody to know how important what we heard was. I think this has given us a chance to really get to one of the most important things that we can do to move ourselves forward as a school district and as the community that we are and the caring community we want to be. So thank you. Thank you all. And we'll bring back I believe we've got consensus that we'll bring back the AERs January 29th. Yes?
Yeah, January 29th.
Yes, okay.
Do you concur with that, January 29th, for action?
Okay.
That's fine.
Okay. And that's what it is,
January 29th.
So thank you all. And we're going to move on to the next item, which is over here. Thank you. Which is D1, Dr. Margaret.